Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for November the 29th of 2019, well, it's titled Galileo's Europa Remastered. So what do we see here? Well, this is one of the large satellites of Jupiter. Jupiter has four large satellites in orbit around it, and they were first seen by Galileo back in the early 1600s when he worked on the telescope. He was not the one to invent it, but he was the first to turn it to the sky and record his observations and publish them. So he was one of the things that he saw. But of course, what would you look at when you're looking at using a new object to look at things? You'd look at some of the brightest objects in the sky. So things like Venus and Jupiter were things that he saw. And one thing that he saw was four moons orbiting around Jupiter, and Europa is one of those moons. Europa is actually the smallest of the four Galilean moons, slightly smaller than our own moon. However, it's also very interesting in that it has an ocean below the surface. It has no atmosphere, so it cannot have liquid water on the surface. It would immediately freeze because of the temperatures and could not exist in a liquid form without some atmospheric pressure. However, it can't. There is a lot of water there. And in fact, Europa has more water on it than the entire Earth, even though it is a much smaller object. And when we look at that, we have to consider that all the water on the Earth is confined to the outer couple miles of the Earth's surface. If you could peel back that outer layer, the Earth would be a very, very dry planet. And you cannot go down hundreds or thousands of miles and expect to find more water. The water, even though we're call ourselves the water planet, is really confined to the outer layer of the surface. So once those oceans, although they are quite deep, they go down a few miles, they don't go down the thousands of miles that you would need to for the entire interior of the Earth. So it's interesting that this object out in the outer solar system has more water on it than the entire Earth. And that's one of the reasons that we always look at it as a possibility for a place to look for living organisms. Not a complex civilization, but certainly that if there is liquid water down there below the surface, that we could possibly find some kind of life there. And one of the thoughts is to send something there to try to be able to determine if we can detect if there is any kind of life that has formed on Europa. So Europa and Mars are two of the best areas within our solar system to try to look for life. Now, how can we have water out in the outer solar system where it is so much colder? We don't have liquid water any longer on Mars, which is only a little bit further away from the sun than the Earth, but we do have this subsurface ocean out on Europa. It all has to do with the tidal forces from Jupiter. Jupiter will pull on objects and stretch and twist them because of its immense gravity. So it heats up Europa inside because of its tidal forces. And that really means that it pulls a little bit more on the closer side than it does on the more distant side of the moon. And as it moves around in an elliptical orbit, it gets stretched and twisted and heated up inside, much as you heat up a ball of clay. By kneading it around with your hands, then that will slowly warm it up. Well, Jupiter has been doing this to Europa for billions of years, meaning that it can be relatively warm inside, and this happens to an even more extreme case on the innermost moon known as Io, which is extremely volcanically active, and for the same reason that it has been heated up inside and is much hotter, even though it's a smaller object or as small an object as our own moon, it still is much hotter inside and very volcanically active. And for a similar reason, we get to see Europa here with its icy surface, and then below an entire ocean of water. So that was our picture of the day for November the 29th of 2019. It was titled Galileo's Europa Remastered. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Red Planet Star Trails. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.